myself Dr. P. Srivastava, and today we will discuss about the thoracic wall and internal thoracic artery, right? So what is a thoracic wall? So the thorax is covered by the muscles of the pectoral region of the upper limb, right? And with head, intercostal muscles and membranes fill up the gaps between adjacent rib and cartilage, right? These muscles provide integrity to the thoracic wall. So right and left pair of the thoracic nerve fulfill the exact definition and supply the thoracic wall. The posterior intercostal vein and posterior intercostal artery and intercostal vein, it all lies from above to downward in the costal group of the ribs, right? And it's supplied by the sympathetic part of the autonomic nervous system, started from the lateral horn of thoracic first to thoracic 12 segment of the spine. Thoracic wall is covered from outside to inside by the muscle, skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, extensic muscles, right? So first we can see muscles of the perineum, in which pectoralis major, trapezius, serratus anterior, pectoralis minor, latissimus dorsi, levator scapulae, rhomboides major, rhomboides minor, serratus posterior superior and serratus posterior inferior. This is the part of the muscles of the upper limb, right? And muscles of the abdomen, rectus abdominis, external oblique, and back, erector spine, ergo spinalis. These muscles which cover the thoracic wall, right? We will see the feature of thoracic cage. The thoracic cage forms the skeleton framework of the wall of thorax. The gap between the ribs are called intercostal space, and they are filled by the intercostal muscles and contain intercostal nerve, vessels and lymphatics. So intercostal muscles, these are the external intercostal muscles, internal intercostal muscles and transverse thoracic muscles, right? These muscles arise from lower border of the ribs, external intercostal, floor of the costal groove, internal costal and inner surface of the rib near the angle, middle two-third of the ridge above the costal groove in transverse thoracic muscles. And which insertion outer lip of upper border, external intercostal, and inner lip of upper border, internal intercostal, and inner surface of 2 or 3 ribs below, and inner lip of upper border of the rib and costal cartilage of 2nd to 6th rib, which inserted transverse thoracics. So this is a thoracic cage where in the muscles fill the gap of the spaces. Right. Now we'll come in internal thoracic artery. Right. So what is the origin? The origin part is the internal thoracic artery arises from the inferior aspect of the first rib. This is the internal thoracic artery and arises from the inferior aspect of the first part of subclavian artery and opposite the thoracocervical trunk and lies 2 cm above the external lip. We will see beginning. The internal thoracic artery arises from the lower border of the first part of subclavian artery. It descends medially and downward behind the external end of the clavicle and first costal cartilage, right? Where it runs vertically downward 2 cm from lateral border of sternum till 6th intercostal space. The artery terminate into 6th intercostal space by the dividing into superior epigastric and musculophrenic artery. Then the artery accompanied by 2 veni cavae committee and unite at the level of 4th costal cartilage from the internal thoracic and internal mammary vein. What is the relation? So we see the relation of internal thoracic artery. Above the first costal cartilage, it runs downward, forward and medially. Right. And behind is situated the external end of the clavicle, internal jugular vein, brachiocephaly vein, first costal cartilage and phrenic nerve. And anterior pectoris major अपर सिक्स कॉस्टल कार्टिलेज, एक्सटर्नल इंटरकॉस्टल मेम्ब्रेन, इंटरनल इंटरकॉस्टल मसल्स एंड द फर्स्ट सिक्स इंटरकॉस्टल नर्व. एंड ऑन द पोस्टीरियर साइड इट इज रिलेशन विद द इंडो थोरेसिक फेशिया एंड प्लूरा अप टू द सेकेंड टू थर्ड कॉस्टल कार्टिलेज. बिलो द लेवल ऑफ स्टर्नोकॉस्टलिस मसल्स सेपरेट द आर्टरी फ्रॉम द प्लूरा. तो व्हाट इज द ब्रांचेस? सो नाउ वी विल सी द ब्रांचेस. दिस इज अ ब्रांचेस ऑफ इंटरनल थोरेसिक आर्टरी. फर्स्ट वन इट गिव्स पेरिकार्डियोफ्रेनिक आर्टरी इन द रूट ऑफ द नेक एंड अकंपनी द फ्रेनिक नर्व टू रीच द डायफ्राम एंड सप्लाई द पेरिकार्डियम एंड द प्लूरा. And mediastinal artery. Mediastinal artery, right? Mediastinal artery is a small irregular bunches and that supply the thymus in front of pericardium and the fat in mediastinum. And two anterior intercostal artery are given to each the upper six intercostal space. This is an anterior intercostal artery which gives 1 to 6 intercostal artery, right? And perforating branch accompanying the anterior cutaneous nerve in the female. The perforating branch in the second, third and fourth space are large and supply the epigastric artery. It also runs downward 7 costal cartilage and enters the rectus sheath by the passing between the external and costal slip of the diaphragm. And musculophrenic artery runs downward and internally behind the 7th, 8th and 9th costal cartilage. It gives 2 anterior intercostal branches to each of these 3 spaces and it perforates the diaphragm near the 9th costal cartilage and terminate by the anastomosis with other arteries on the undersurface of the diaphragm. Right. So this is the branches where in the thoracic artery supply in different parts and adjusting part of the thoracic wall. So this is a main and important artery which occurs in the thoracic cavity. Okay, right? Thank you guys very much.